With March Madness officially underway, here are my top five NBA prospects playing in the NCAA tournament that I'll be watching over the next few weeks. At number five, Scotty Barnes out of Florida State, one of the most unique prospects in the entire country. 6'9", 7'3" wingspan, but plays really anywhere from 1 to 5 on both ends of the floor. He'll pick up 94 feet, sliding with point guards, and then also bring the ball up offensively. He can really, really pass it, sees over the top of the defense. He's not a great perimeter shooter, shooting under 30% from three so far. Not the most consistent scorer in the half court, but he's a winning player. He has 3 gold medals to his name with the USA Junior National Team. He was a leader on one of the best high school teams of all time alongside Cade Cunningham, Moses Moody, Dayron Sharp at Montverde. So he has that winning pedigree. Reminds me a little bit of a more modern Draymond Green. I think if a team decides to put shooting around him and allow him to play that small ball 4 or 5 spot, he could be one of the more dynamic undersized bigs in the entire NBA. So I look for Scotty Barnes to have a winning impact all tournament long, and his versatility is a big reason why he's a projected top 10 pick in this draft. At number four, Keon Johnson out of Tennessee, arguably the most explosive athlete in the entire draft. 6'5", 190 pound wiry frame, but he is a head at the rim type of athlete, a big time finisher, and impacts winning all over the floor. He's a little bit unconventional because he's got a combo guard size, but he's not really the most sure-handed ball handler. He's shooting under 30% from three so far this season, but he's a fill-in-the-gaps type of guy. He's a tremendous cutter. He's a great offensive rebounder. He's an instinctual off-ball defender. So teams who are going to draft him in the top 10 are really looking at not what he is now, but what he could become in the future, because he's really just scratching the surface in terms of his upside. At number three, Jalen Suggs out of Gonzaga. He's the best player on arguably the best team we've ever seen in the history of college basketball at 19 years old. So that speaks to his maturity, his ability to come in right away and have an impact in the NBA at that age. So incredibly poised, plays with a great spirit and energy about him that you rarely see from a projected top 5 pick. You know, he plays both ends of the floor. He has incredible instincts defensively in the passing lanes. He's a great positional rebounder. Defensively, he reminds me a little bit of Drew Holiday, just being that sturdy defender who's not afraid of contact, who can defend multiple positions, rebounds his position. But then offensively, he's much more dynamic in the open court. He's not afraid of contact. He loves to get downhill to the rim. He's improved as a perimeter shooter. And we've seen him show up when the lights are bright against BYU, West Coast Conference Tournament Championship. He made big shot after big shot down the stretch. That's in his DNA. So Jalen Suggs has that star potential that's going to show in March and eventually in the NBA. Number two, Evan Mobley out of USC. He's the next great unicorn-style big to play in the NBA. 7 feet tall, 7'5 wingspan, moves like a wing on both ends of the floor. He's ideal defensively in the modern NBA because he can switch every ball screen. He defends the perimeter at a high level and then also has tremendous shot-blocking instincts around the rim. Excellent timing. He's quick off his feet. So he really fits the modern game on the defensive end of the floor. He's a little bit slight, needs to improve his body, could stand to get a little bit tougher, but that should come with his physical maturation. And then offensively, he's just scratching the surface. He's incredibly unique with his ability to handle the ball almost like a point setter in transition. He can pass it from all over the floor. He can play out of the mid post. He has touch shots out of the short roll. He's stepping out and shooting the three ball a little bit. So he's really a ball of clay on the offensive end of the floor. Shows you these little glimpses, but 3, 4, or 5 years down the line, we could be talking about an Anthony Davis caliber player in terms of a two-way big who protects the rim, who moves incredibly well, and who can score and facilitate from all over the floor. So Evan Mobley has as high of an upside as any prospect in this draft. Number one, Cade Cunningham, the clear-cut top prospect in the entire draft and arguably one of the best players in all of college basketball at just 19 years old. And NBA teams love his versatility. He's someone that you could use as a big ball handler in the Luka Doncic role. 6'8", can see over the top, can make every pick and roll read, wants the ball in his hands late clock, loves those step back threes, the knockout punch, late clock situations. He wants the ball in his hands, so he can play that role. Or he can play the wing scorer role like a Jason Tatum. He can catch and shoot. He can operate from the mid post. He has the tools to defend multiple positions. Or you can use him like a Chris Middleton as a secondary ball handler who can play out of those second side pick and rolls, make players around him better, and score it at all three levels. So his versatility is highly coveted in today's NBA. Every team wants that 6'8" ball handler who can pass, dribble, shoot. That's the holy grail in today's NBA, and Cade Cunningham is exactly that. He's incredibly mature. You sit down with him, spend some time with him, you feel like you're talking to an NBA veteran. So this is a kid who's going to come in right away and have a major impact, not just as a scorer, but as a facilitator, making everyone else around him better and impacting winning at a high level. He is a superstar in the making and the clear-cut number one prospect in this draft.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.